I would like to thank all the government delegates and the experts who contributed substantially to the Africa Regional Report. And what I am going to present here, Mr. Chairman, is basically a brief summary of the main findings and recommendations. And the document has actually been distributed and sent to the government delegates and experts. Next, please. The outline of my presentation is basically that I'm going to talk about the objectives of the operational review and also delve a little bit on the technical tools and analysis, and I will give an overview of the main findings and some of the main recommendations or priorities for the future. Next, please. With regard to the objectives of the operational review, Mr. Chairman, this review is basically for renewing and heightening the political commitment to the implementation of the ICBD program of action in the continent, and also to document the achievements and the factors that facilitated or hampered the progress, and to identify the gaps and the unfinished agenda and the emerging issues, as well as also to identify the priorities for the future, because we're talking about the ICBD beyond 2014, and therefore we have to talk about or identify the priorities for the future. Next, please. The analysis in the main report is based mainly on the results of the survey as it has been administered in the continent. And the survey basically covers some important elements which are summarized as follows. That first, there is good coverage of the institutional structures. Those are policies, programs, and strategies, and institutional entities that governments put in place to implement the program of action. And also the ICBD actions and priorities and how they have been addressed at the national and the regional level through the budgetary allocations and concrete implementation measures, and the assessment and research to inform policies, programs, and support decisions, and also partnership with the CSOs, NGOs, youth organizations, and international corporations. And it is really gratifying that this time 52 countries participated in the survey, compared to 43 in 2009, 43 in 2004, and 41 countries in 1999. So the number really reflects commitment, and I'm really glad to say here that Southern Sudan for the first time contributed to this review. Next. The second source of information, Mr. Chairman, is basically the country reports. And on this element, African countries stand out as really clear that there is no other region that prepared country reports. And we received country reports from 27 countries, and the country reports provide a narrative and text to ascertain ownership and commitment to the program of action, and to align the program of action with the development, national development priorities, as well as also the MDGs and the agenda post-2015, and to analyze the achievements and document best practices, narrative and text on the best practices, and also to analyze the facilitating factors and the challenges that countries faced, and to provide recommendations, and we received a large number of good recommendations on the priorities for the future. And this is really a very unique and very important analysis that will definitely shape the recommendations for the future. Next, please. Well, in the analysis of the May report, we have tried to answer some fundamental questions. And these questions are basically, how did the countries address the ICPD priorities and issues during the last 5 years? And what are the achievements, the gaps, and the unfinished agenda? And what are the facilitating factors? And what are the barriers and constraints? And what are the level of implementation? To what extent the countries implemented the program of action priorities? And what is the extent of using research to inform policies, programs, and budgetary allocations? And what is the role of partnership with the CSOs? And what are the priorities for the future? Next, please. Well, here on this slide, I would like to say that the analysis was conducted at the regional level for the 52 countries. But also, the data is rich, and it really provides very good information when you conduct the analysis by the sub-regional geographical parts of the continent. Northern Africa, 6 countries. Western Africa, 15 countries. Central Africa, 7 countries. East Africa, 13 countries. And Southern Africa, 11 countries. And this geographical diversity really gives a lot of in-depth comparative analysis of the results. But we have conducted the analysis also, and this is for the first time, at the level of the regional economic communities, the RECs. And we have used the RECs that are recognized by both AUC and ECA. And these are the UMA, 4 countries, ECAS, 6 countries, ECOWAS, 15 countries, IGAD, SADC, COMESA, SINSAD, and EAC. And actually, when you take that dimension of the regional economic communities, which most of them existed after 1994 when the conference was adopted in Cairo, that you really see a very important and very interesting variations. And that is basically included in the May report. Next, please. Next, please. Now, here, I would like to draw your attention to the bars. The red bar basically indicates the number of the countries that answered the question. And the blue bar shows the countries that have said yes in terms of the implementation, in terms of allocating budgetary resources and other implementation tools in terms of programs and policies. And you can see here that the area of reproductive health, as Kwabena said, is really an area that received top priority in our region. That there is a lot of progress in the area of reproductive health. There are lots of achievements. I don't want to go over them one by one. But I would like to identify the gaps because these are very important. If you look down the graph, you will see that support to abortion services to the extent of the law is very low in terms of the participation. And the gap between the blue and the red bars is very big, which means that there is a gap in this area. There is also gap in the area of increasing access of sexual or reproductive health services to persons with disabilities, to all the persons, to indigenous population groups, which is to a large extent exactly what the previous speaker found. I would like to also emphasize the importance here of the fact that our countries have actually in this area developed so many policies and programs, and they implemented them, and the agenda is really, the progress of this agenda is quite impressive. Next, please. The second agenda that has actually also received priority in our continent is gender equality, equity, and the empowerment of women. And the achievements are quite clear there, basically increasing women's participation in political processes and public life, increasing women's participation in the formal economy, and ending gender-based violence. Still also, there are gaps, and the gaps are clear in the area of ending FGM, and also in the area of preventing trafficking and smuggling in persons, particularly girls and women. And in the area of collecting and analyzing data on the social and economic status of women. These are the gaps that we have managed to identify, and they are the ones that we really need to prioritize in the programs and activities for the future. Next, please. The third area here is basically population, sustained economic growth, and sustainable development. And there is very good progress in the continent with regard to eradicating poverty through income generation and employment strategies, and also in terms of strengthening food security and promoting environmental resource management. But still, gaps exist in the area of achieving fair trade relations, the bottom of the graph. And also, there is very clear gap in addressing the population trends and dynamics in ecologically vulnerable areas, and also addressing the needs of people in fragile ecosystems. And these are areas that really needs our attention for the agenda beyond 2014. Next, please. This one here is basically population development and education. And there is also quite significant progress in the education systems in our countries, particularly enrollment of girls in schools. But also gaps exist in terms of improving the safety of pupils and girls, especially girls, and in terms of incorporating population and sexual reproductive health into the education curricula, and in the facilitating school completion for pregnant girls. Let me say here that the country reports provide really documentation of some very good best practices, and I'd really encourage you to read those good practices in the country reports, because these are not covered in the survey. There is really very good information on that in the country reports. Next, please. The family well-being of individuals and society. This is an area where also our countries have made progress and achievements, particularly increasing efforts to ensure health, education, and welfare services, and to also support and assist vulnerable families. But still, as you can see from the difference between the red and the blue bar, that the gaps still exist. And this really means that we need to do more in terms of supporting the families, particularly to assist families to care after the persons with disabilities and HIV/AIDS, and to also develop capacities to monitor impact of the families and well-being of families, and to support the educational programs concerning parental roles, parental skills, and child development. Next, please. Urbanization and internal migration, an area that is usually not very well covered in the previous rounds of reviews, but this time we have plenty of information on it. And you all know that this trend of urbanization and internal migration is really very high in our countries. And when you look at the answers that we received through the questionnaire, that there is progress and there are gaps. And the progress is basically in the area of promoting decentralization. So many countries actually documented this in the country reports to reduce the pressure of internal migration, the pressure of rural urban migration. There is also progress in the area of promoting growth of small, medium-sized urban centers. And we see that these are really developing rapidly. But there is gap with regard to ensuring land, housing, services, and livelihood for the urban poor. It's clear that the cities are growing with large number of slums. There is also need to integrate rural urban migrants in the urban areas and to adopt proactive planning for urban population growth. We know that our urban areas are really absorbing most of the population growth in our countries, and we really need to pay more attention to the demographics of the urban populations. Next, please. Adolescents and youth. Look at the bars and the difference between them, the red and the blue. There is progress with regard to creating employment opportunities for youth. And our governments have actually done a lot of good work on this area. But down the graph, when you look at how the impact of poverty on our youth, there is gap, which means that we really need to do more intensive research on how poverty is impacting negatively on our youth population. Youth are the future of our continent, and therefore we need to ensure that they receive adequate care and they're also engaged in the development process. Next, please. Older persons. 5% of the population in Africa are older persons. But when you look at the numbers, they're actually increasing fast. And also, it is really commendable that our countries during the last 5 or 10 years or so, they are really progressing very well in terms of policies, programs addressing the needs of older persons, particularly the health needs of older persons. But this is an area where gaps still exist, and we need to do more, particularly to promote employment opportunities for older persons, and also to institute concrete measures and procedures for their participation in development, and to provide support to families that are caring after older persons. Next, please. Persons with disabilities. This is an area where statistics is really deficient in our continent, but generally, we believe that it is between 15 to 20% of our populations are really with different kinds of disabilities, meaning that disability is much higher in terms of numbers compared to older persons. That is because of the fact that you see that conflict and diseases have caused those disabilities. And it's an area where we really need to pay more attention to, particularly in terms of providing support to families caring for persons with disabilities, and also collecting data and promoting equality by ensuring reasonable accommodation in all aspects of life. And we need to really integrate disability in our development plans and strategies, particularly accessing the physical environment. We need to also address their needs and the health issues. They usually say, nothing for us without us. Please, next, please. Indigenous people. The problem here mainly is that the issue of recognition, identity, protection of the environment in which they live, that in our countries, indigenous people are really at the very marginal of the development process. very little statistics, very little information, and as you can see that from the survey, only half of the countries that responded to the questionnaire or participated in the questionnaire responded. And those who responded, few of them actually took actions. And most of those few countries are in the Southern Africa sub-region. It's an area where we really need to do a little bit of more, we need to do a lot of more research, collecting data, and also providing and protecting the environment in which indigenous people live. Next, please. International migration, as you all know, is a mega trend in our continent, and we believe that much of the international migration, or about 64-65% of it, is within the continent. And the gaps are very big here, and it's an area where we really need to develop policies and implement them. Next, please. This slide here shows the overall progress with regard to implementation measures. And this is actually the answer to the question on whether implementation is on schedule or not. And as you can see, that implementation in most of our countries is behind schedule. Only 9% were on schedule, and 3% ahead of schedule. So there is really need to take actions and implement them on time. Now, next, please. Let me just very briefly, because I've received a lot of recommendations from our countries, but it is important, in my opinion, to sustain the achievements, because this is an area where we have usually experienced setbacks, particularly in some countries. Maternal mortality, after improving, then you see it going down again. We have experienced that in connection with life expectancy at birth, and that is extremely important that we really sustain the achievements. And also, it is important to take action on time. Delayed implementation will incur high social cost. It is also important to target gaps in the implementation of the ICBD agenda and to promote coordination and cooperation among sector ministries. Next, please. There is need also to harmonize population policies with sectoral policies in our countries. And that has actually been expressed very clearly in the reports. There is need to promote partnership with CSOs, and also need to address the cultural and behavioral barriers and the factors that constrain the implementation of the program of action in our countries. Next, please. It is important to adequately staff and fund national and regional population programs and to address the shortages in skills and capacities in the area of population and development. We have few demographers in the continent, and we really need to build experience and to build specialization in this area. And to address also the paucity of data and analysis, and to promote registration of births and deaths. And finally, it is important to register and provide IDs for all the persons and persons with disabilities. And this has actually one of the recommendations that came out in the country report. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.